Yeah, you know what's funny? I don't remember his name, but I remember what he does. Is that funny? Like, he's like, what character did I play? Foot Fetish. My name is Ian Marichal. I'm from the planet Brooklyn. How long have you been acting?
Yes.
Well, I started off in theater. My dad had a theater company when I was a kid, so maybe like 9. So then I got away from it because I thought that's like, I was just doing it because that's what my dad wanted me to do, but then I realized how much I loved it and came back to it years later. You know what's funny? I don't remember his name, but I remember what he does. Is that funny? Like, what character did I play? Foot Fetish.
First date, you played the character of
James.
James. James. 8 inches James.
8 inches James. Elements. Yeah, definitely. Yeah. People I know that just have like weird things that they actually aren't scared to talk about. Yes, I do know. They will remain nameless, but they're not me. Honestly, I love the director. And I said yes before I even thought. And then when I read the character, I was like, all right, I understand. I don't think anything was challenging. When I think of the word challenge, I think it was just a lot of fun. Like I had a lot of fun. So the director, Taliba, I was actually talking to my friend Chuck about this, how she's really good at allowing people, giving people freedom and giving people permission. And it's a really subtle trait that like not a lot of directors have. That was really funny. And there's a lot to work with, and I like playing kind of like quirky, weird characters and trying to make, you know, trying to find the truth in it.
That was dope. We didn't have it in here, which was lovely, but it was a surprise. It was like, whoa, wait, what?
I feel like, in a way, it has elements of some like old school sitcom kind of stuff, like scenarios, like 80s kind of, was like really like a sitcom. Like there's a situation every week and she has to figure it out. So that's the first thing that comes to me, is just like, it's like a real situation comedy. First dates is universal. So I think any and everybody who's ever been on a date will appreciate it. And that's what's really cool, because it's such a specific thing, but when you make something really specific, it's universal. So it really is about this girl trying to get her life back together and these kind of wild and wacky dates she goes on, but everybody can relate to that. She's super cool, man. Again, it was such a relaxed set. She was great to work with. Angela was great to work with. Everybody on the set was, it was such a cool family environment, so we just bugged out, man. And I love that about comedy. That's what I used to love about Living Color. What I used to love about Living Color was, you know that they were laughing. Or like Martin, you know that they were laughing. And it made you, even though you didn't see them crack all the time, it like made you laugh. My favorite restaurant, I can't even pronounce the name, but it's this Greek restaurant, 14th and 1st. Caladius Taverna.
Caladius.
Something like that. Yeah, and I really, really, really like it.
What do they serve? Why is it your favorite restaurant?
Because you just get a bunch of appetizers, and when I was a kid, my dad, we would go to this place called Delphi in the city, like right near the Brooklyn Bridge, and he'd always get like souvlaki and rice, and I think that's also a part of it. That place isn't there anymore, and there's just like the sentimental kind of value behind that, like just driving into the city with my dad and my mom, and my mom playing the Dirty Dancing soundtrack. And like just singing every song with her, so I think that's part of why. And the food is amazing. And it's a good price, like it's priced well. Working with Taliba is great. It's an amazing, everybody should try it. I've been working with Taliba for what? It was like 5 years? 5 years? No.
2009.
Yeah. This really? 6 years. I worked with Taliba for 6 years. I was there at the very beginning. It's been great to see her grow as a director, and see her really like settle into her craft and like her vision. And I love working with her. And like I said, she could call me tomorrow, like she did that day, and was just like, can you do this? I'm gonna be there. There's been some humdingers, man. Wait, let's see. Can I think about this for a second?
Yeah.
Can we come back to that question?
Yeah.